We'll start off by asking you a couple of questions about your father. Your father, Dory Funk Sr., he's also a wrestling legend in the southern U.S. Are there any fond memories you would like to share with us about your father?
Well, there's several things. My father was my trainer. Mm-hmm. He was my coach. He was my business partner. And if I think back to the memories, I remember when I first asked my father, I said, gee, I'd like to become a professional wrestler. His answer surprised me. He said, you're about to enter the most competitive business in the world, and I didn't really understand that. But in truth, it did turn out that way. The highlight of my career up until now was February 11, 1969, when I won the NWA World title from Gene Kaminsky. Right. My father was at my side. And he said, after it was over, he put his arm around me and he said, if you never accomplish anything else, you've done a hell of a lot. Now here we are, some 40 years later, and I'm just absolutely amazed being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. And this, coming up in Houston at the WWE Hall of Fame, will be the highlight of my career. Wow. And it's just amazing. There's always been something to look forward to in professional wrestling. Mm-hmm. And even at the present time, we are training some outstanding young kids here that are going to make future professional wrestlers here at the Funkin Conservatory mm-hmm. in Ocala, Florida. And I'm proud of the wrestlers that have come through our training system. And actually, we've got 6 wrestlers on WrestleMania. Mm-hmm. That's Matt Hardy, Jeff Hardy, Edge,
Christian,
mm-hmm. Mickey James, mm-hmm. and Mark Henry.
Were there any talks, or could there possibly be talks to add the fucking conservatory as a developmental territory, as well as Florida championship out there in Florida?
Well, we would love and enjoy an association with any of the major wrestling companies, which we do have now. We are the official training center for All Japan Pro Wrestling mm-hmm. In America. And we do have good relations, as you can imagine, with WWE, mm-hmm. TNA, many of the Japanese wrestling companies. And we have the marketing facilities here at the Funkin Conservatory to get our wrestlers out to where they can be seen through our Bang television show. And that's video online, and it's very popular, and wrestlers can come here and appear on Bang television, and they can be seen worldwide
right.
by their families, by potential employers, by anybody interested in professional wrestling.
You graduated from West Texas A&M University. It was West Texas State when you were there.
Yes, West Texas State University during my case.
It can be best described as a breeding ground for some of wrestling's top stars of the 70s and the 80s. You know, Dusty Rhodes, Chico Santana, Tito Santana, Stan Hansen, and, of course, DiBiase, Blitchard, and even your brother, Terry. They're all alumni.
These are brothers, another one not to be forgotten. Bobby Duncan also.
They all got their starts from your father's Amarillo territory.
I think it was the influence of my father in the area
mm-hmm.
That created the interest. And it was the success that Terry and I had coming from West Texas State University and having success in the wrestling business. And that spawned a lot of interest, and there were some good athletes there.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you even had a chance to feud with your, not feud with him, but team with your dad earlier in your career.
Yes, I did. I teamed with my father and my brother. In fact, we had some quite famous matches. I remember going to Mid-Atlantic to Greensboro where Terry, my father, and myself mm-hmm. were in a 6-man team, and it was resulted at the time in the largest crowd attracted to the Greensboro Coliseum. And I enjoyed wrestling with my father. It was kind of like having your teacher in your corner ready to correct you at any moment. You know? I really did enjoy working with him as a tag team partner, and also with Terry, too. Much of my career came through, he was centered over here in America, but also in Japan. And Terry and I became very famous in Japan as tag team partners. In fact, I think we're the only ones to become three-time world tag team world champions in Japan.
Right. Now, with saying that, did Terry and yourself suffer any discrimination from other, you know, young wrestlers when you were first started out due to being the son of an established wrestler?
You know, my father pretty much took care of that. We were treated no better than anybody else, and if he felt like correcting us, he did it in no uncertain terms and in front of everybody. And the result was the other wrestlers would get behind us and say, "Hey, you know, you're not that bad." he handled that real well. He did a good job of that.
All right.
I've grown to appreciate it in later years.
You and Terry purchased the territory from the friend of the family, Doc Sarpolis, your father's longtime partner, after he passed in 67. Had you two, you and Terry, already been involved in booking at the territory before you actually purchased it?
Boy, you're up on your history.
Oh, man. The producers are doing
actually, my first involvement in the booking of the territory was working with the father of the Million Dollar Man. I was working with Mike DiBiase, Iron Mike DiBiase.
Okay.
And we used to travel together and do the booking of the territory. Iron Mike DiBiase was a brilliant man and really somebody to learn from. And I can even remember young Teddy DiBiase watching his father wrestling in the ring in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And Iron Mike was in the ring setting the heat on Ricky Romero, and the fans were about to riot, and Teddy DiBiase was running back and forth facing the fans, mm-hmm. tears running down his face, saying, "Stop yelling at my father." So I go back a long ways, but yeah, Iron Mike DiBiase was a real influence on my career.
Now, you brought up this several times, but 4.5 years, man, you held the title. You won over Gene Kudinski to win the NWA World Heavyweight Championship in 69. You would hold it for 4.5 years. That's only second to Lou Thesz, man. When did you know that the NWA wanted you to be their champion?
I can take you back through history. There was a meeting of the National Wrestling Alliance, and my father called Terry and I together. And he says, it's possible that one of you guys could become world champion. Mm-hmm. And he just laid it out. He said, it's not a two-sided thing. I can't train both of you guys. We've got to select one and the whole family get behind it. Mm-hmm. And with that, Terry said, let's go with Dory. And that was before I could even speak up. Mm-hmm. And I trained for 6 months with my father, with my brother, with another wrestler named Ricky Romero. And it was hard work and everything. And it wound up with me targeting and fortunately winning the NWA World Championship from Gene Kudinski in Tampa, Florida.
Being one of the longest reigning world champions in the history of this industry, that's got to be huge for you.
Every night was a thrill. Every night to perform in front of the wrestling fans. I actually, honestly, wound up wrestling about 300, more than 300 nights a year for 4.5 years. And spending lots and lots of time in the ring. I wrestled Jack Briscoe probably 150 times. Most matches lasting a full hour, some of them going 90 minutes. Mm-hmm. It's an honor to be returning to Houston, Texas. That's where I had huge success with famous matches against Wahoo McDaniel and Johnny Valentine. In fact, with Wahoo, I wrestled him for 90 minutes at the same Houston Coliseum. Incidentally, right now, here in the Funky Conservatory Wrestling School, Wahoo McDaniel Jr. Mm-hmm. is training with us. He's 20 years old right now and doing a great job. And we're looking forward to a lot of